Hi class, this is Sir Sly and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, we will talk about the second part of our discussion on the circulatory system. So this video now, the part 2, will focus on blood circulation. So we will briefly discuss what blood circulation is and the three types of blood circulation. Okay, so what is blood circulation? Blood circulation is the passage of blood throughout the body under the influence of pressure exerted by the heart. So in Filipino, ito po yung pagdaloy ng dugo sa iba't ibang parte ng katawan sa tulong ng pressure na ini-exert ng puso natin kapag ito ay nagpa-pump ng dugo. Okay? So that is blood circulation. We have three types of blood circulation. The first one is coronary circulation. So as we all know, the heart pumps blood to the different parts of our body. And syempre, hindi niya pwedeng kalimutan yung kanyang sarili. Okay, so it also has to provide blood to itself. And along with the blood, of course, are the nutrients and oxygen it needs in order for it to function properly. Okay, so hindi lang syempre dapat yung ibang parts ng katawan ng dinadaluyan ng dugo. Ultimo mismo yung ating puso ay kailangan din ng dugo at ng mga sustansya na meron dito. Okay, so sir, coronary circulation is the movement of blood through the tissue of the heart. So that is basically the coronary circulation, yung pagdaloy ng dugo sa mga ugat na matatagpuan sa ating puso. So if you will notice, we have different arteries here in the picture. Arteries that cover the heart. We have the right coronary artery, left main coronary artery, circumflex coronary artery, and then the left anterior descending coronary arteries. Lahat po yan ng mga blood vessels na yan ay nagpo-provide ng oxygenated blood. So it gives oxygen and then also nutrients for the heart. The second type of blood circulation is the pulmonary circulation. It is the circulation of blood between the heart and the lungs. As you all know, merong connection ang circulatory system at ang respiratory system. The goal of pulmonary circulation is to provide the blood with oxygen. So, kailangan ng katawan natin ng oxygen. Meron tayong tinatawag na pulmonary circulation para mag-supply ng oxygen sa ating dugo. Paano ba nangyayari ang pulmonary circulation? Let's zoom into the picture. Yeah. So, try to notice. Remember that the heart pumps blood to every organ in our body, including the lungs. Now, ang main purpose ng pagpapump ng heart ng blood papunta sa lungs ay para po makapagpalitan niya ng oxygen at ng carbon dioxide. Okay? Yung oxygen na kukunin ng dugo mula sa lungs ay siyang didistribute naman ng puso sa iba't ibang parte ng katawan. Now, let's take a closer look at the blood vessels involved in pulmonary circulation. So, try to notice that the blood vessel, which is color blue, signifies that this blood vessel carries the oxygenated blood. Tapos yung kulay pula naman, they carry oxygenated blood. So yung dugo na nanggaling sa iba't ibang part ng katawan natin ay deoxygenated pa. Ibig sabihin wala pa ang oxygen. So it will go here sa receiving chamber natin, which is the right atrium. And then the right atrium will pump the blood towards the right ventricle, and then the right ventricle will pump the blood papunta sa lungs through the pulmonary arteries. So the pulmonary artery is the only artery in our body that carries the oxygenated blood. So once the blood reaches the lungs, it will now become oxygenated. Okay? Now once oxygenated, bibit-bitin naman siya ng pulmonary veins. Okay? So, pulmonary veins pabalik sa heart. Unlike the other veins in our body, pulmonary veins carry oxygenated blood. Okay, so kaya siya kulay pula. This oxygenated blood will be received here in the left atrium, and then it will go to the left ventricle, and then the left ventricle, having the thickest wall of the heart, will pump the blood, the oxygenated blood, towards the different parts of the body or to the different parts of our body through the aorta. Okay, so if we are to trace the pathway of blood in a pulmonary circulation, ito po. So magisimula yung dugo sa right atrium, which is deoxygenated pa, papunta sa right ventricle. Then the right ventricle will pump the deoxygenated blood to the lungs through the pulmonary artery. And then the blood will go to the lungs where it will become oxygenated. And then this oxygenated blood will be carried by the pulmonary vein, and it will be received by the left atrium, and then delivered to the left ventricle, which will be pumped to the different parts of our body. Okay, so pulmonary circulation. Now, the third type of blood circulation is the systemic circulation. Systemic circulation is the circulation of blood from the heart to the different parts of our body. Ito yung circulation matapos mangyari ang pulmonary circulation. Kasi ang goal ng systemic circulation ay to provide the body tissues or cells with nutrients, oxygen, and water. Okay, so meron ng oxygen yung dugo, kailangang i-deliver na sa iba't ibang parte ng katawan. So, ito na po yung pinagsamang pulmonary at systemic circulation. Ito yung pulmonary circulation. And this one, yung pa-vertical, is yung sa systemic. Okay, so, kapag naging oxygenated na yung dugo natin, it will be pumped by the left ventricle. Dadaanan ng dugo ay ang aorta, ang pinakamalaking blood vessel po sa katawan natin. The aorta will deliver the blood towards different arteries in our body. So, pwedeng pataas or pwedeng pa baba. Let me give you some example of a systemic circulation. For example, the heart will pump blood to the liver. Okay, so ano-ano yung mga blood vessel or yung mga parts na dadaanan ng ating dugo papunta sa liver at babalik sa heart. So mag-umpisa yan sa left ventricle. Oxygenated blood mula sa left ventricle ay padadaanin sa aorta. And then from the aorta, dadaan ang oxygenated blood sa hepatic artery. So left ventricle, aorta, and then hepatic artery, and then to the liver. So yung oxygen sa blood na nanggaling sa puso ay kukunin na ng liver along with the other nutrients. And then ang mangyayari, ibibigay naman ng liver yung mga metabolic waste and yung carbon dioxide babalik sa dugo. Okay? So ang mangyayari, deoxygenated na yung dugo. So the deoxygenated blood will now travel through the hepatic vein. Okay, so from the hepatic vein, dadaan yung dugo naman sa inferior vena cava. Meron tayong dalawang klase ng vena cava, yung inferior at saka yung superior vena cava. Pag sinabi mong inferior vena cava, ito po yung blood vessel na nagbibitbit ng deoxygenated blood mula sa lower part ng katawan natin. Kapag superior naman, ito yung deoxygenated blood na nanggaling mula sa upper part ng katawan. So, since ang liver ay nasa lower part, inferior vena cava po ang mag-deliver ng deoxygenated blood papunta sa. Okay, so from the inferior vena cava, dadali na yung dugo, papunta sa receiving chamber of the heart, the right atrium. And then we'll go back to the pulmonary circulation para magkaroon na naman ng oxygen dun sa dugo. Okay? Another example, kidney. So, same thing. Left ventricle magsisimula, oxygenated blood will go to the aorta. From the aorta, it will be carried by the renal artery and then to the kidney. So, the oxygen and nutrients will be delivered to the kidneys and then the kidney will return carbon dioxide and metabolic waste. So, deoxygenated na yung blood natin nun. So, the deoxygenated blood will go to the renal vein, then to the inferior vena cava. Inferior pa rin kasi ang kidney natin ay nasa lower part ng katawan. And then, from the inferior vena cava, the blood will be received by the right atrium. So, that is another example of a systemic circulation. So, those are the three types of blood circulation. So, review lang natin. We have the coronary circulation, where the blood is being moved or delivered to the heart itself. We have the pulmonary circulation, where the blood is carried to the lungs, in which the goal is to provide oxygen to the blood. And then the third type of blood circulation is the systemic circulation, which main goal is to provide oxygen to the different parts of our body, and at the same time, remove the carbon dioxide and metabolic waste in the different organs. So, those are the three types of blood circulation. So, I hope meron kayong natutunan na naman sa ating discussion about the circulatory system. I hope this will help you in your online classes. So, if you like this video, do not forget to hit the like button. And if you are not yet a subscriber, hit the subscribe button and notification bell para mag-updated ka sa mga future videos ko. So, again, this is Sir Sly. Thank you for watching and always remember not to study hard, but to study smart. See you next meeting. Bye, class!